Guys, Dow Phoenix here, and this is the second part of checking out the 340-in-1 NES Super Games cartridge. Basically, we're checking like four pages at a time. We already checked out several games. I'm sure that some of these are the actual games, and so we didn't really bother looking at them. We're mainly looking at... I looked at the Contra ones, because there was a shitload of Contra variations, as well as... I looked at some of the ones that clearly didn't exist or were just kind of oddities. So we're going to go ahead and move on to this page here. So these all look familiar except for Mario 10, Mario 12, and Mario 14. We're going to have to check out all of these. I never heard of any of these. Kung Fu Mari. Oh, okay, this is Jackie Chan's Action Kung Fu, I think. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's what this is. But for some reason, it's got a weird little waving effect with the sprites. So if you want to play a version of Jackie Chan's Action Kung Fu on the NES with a Mario sprite, that's what Mario 10 is. Alright, let's check out Mario 12 then. Okay, this one I think might be a puzzle game. Oh, okay. This is Yoshi's Cookie, I think. Except Mario-flavored? I suppose? I have no idea how to... Oh, okay. Yeah, never mind. Huh. This is kind of a weird puzzle game. Mario 12, people. Let's check out Mario 14, bitches. Mario 14. Oh, shoot, I said bitches. I might not be able to monetize this. Crap. It's made in 1993 by Wario. What the hell, man? Oh, I think this is, what is this freaking game? It's on the tip of my tongue. You can't jump on enemies. I'm just confused about it because I'm playing as Mario, clearly. But it doesn't play like a Mario game. He shoots fireballs with his staff. And that's how you kill the enemies. But this is a pretty inventive little ROM hack. They could have just been lazy and been like, hey, let's just do the Mario. I have no idea how I did that. Oh, okay. Oh, that's a jump technique. Okay. So I think this might be a game we actually got, and it's just a ROM hack. Like I said, I'm going to put the title of the game below, in case you're interested. If I find out what it is, that is. Alright, so let's check out Warwolf. I don't think that I've ever even heard of that game. Pretty badass little intro music. Oh, I think I know what this might be. This is known in the U.S. as Werewolf. Apparently the Japanese version is Warwolf. Okay. And for some reason, a version of a Bobo is in this game. This guy's really easy. Bad collision detection too, holy crap. Man, this is not a good way to start a game off, okay? Okay. And now we become the werewolf, bitches. Hell yeah. Or the warwolf, since it's the Japanese version. That's right, now we are the warwolf. Alright, yeah, this is the same game that we got, it's just a different title. Whatever. Alright, Hot Blood Basketball, Ice Hockey, New Reco, Soccer 2, Volleyball. So these are all different Kunio Kun games here. I think we might have got the Ice Hockey one, I have no idea what New Reco is, let's check it out. Okay, this is the Okay, this is the Olympic one. I could have actually covered this with the Retro Olympics. I have no freaking clue, man. I guess you can buy stuff with the medals that you earn. Yeah, no idea, man. I guess we'll try an event out. I'm not sure how to... I have no idea how to play this. No idea how to run properly. Like, he's all running and shit. So this is like a 400 meter hurdle race. You know what? This is like a badass game. I just can't figure out how to play it. Like, you can tell it's just badass, man. There's all this shit going on. Like, if this is a game we didn't get, we deserved it. For sure. I have no idea how to move forward, though. That's the thing. I wonder if it's like rapidly tapping the D-pad or something. Yeah, I think it might be, because I'm actually sort of catching up. And I'm just not doing a very good job of it. But yeah, that's kind of fun. Okay, like I said, these Kunio-kun games, a lot of them came out only in Japan, so we're not going to understand the dialogue of them. Apparently they made a second soccer one. Guess we'll check that out. Oh, yeah, yeah. Oh, wait, I'm playing as the number one down here. Okay. That's AI players. You can talk by pressing the button, I guess? That's weird. Huh? Whatever. What the hell was... What? What is going on? This is so awesome, though, dude. This is like a good variation of soccer, dude. I like this game. Holy... What the hell? Is that some kind of power-up or some shit that they were using? How do they switch characters? Doesn't appear to be a way to do so, fortunately. Okay, so apparently hitting the A button did various things there. This is a weird-ass soccer game, dude. Some crazy shit going on here. We're not even going to bother checking them out. But we can all tell they're Kunio-kun games. They're hot blood. Check it and see. Bird Fighter. I'm not familiar with that particular title. I think this might be a Japanese-only game. We'll see. Oh, it's freaking Power Rangers! Hell yes! Let's do the Bringer Sword, why not? Why is it called Bird Fighter, though? That doesn't make sense. This is a pretty good playing game, though, man. Plays kind of like Ninja Gaiden or something like that. It's a shame we didn't get this one if that's the case. Yeah, this one's definitely a top-notch looking game, man. It's a shame we didn't get this one, for sure. At least that I know of. Crap. Well, we have it now, thanks to the advent of the internet and multi-cartridges like this, man. We can play games like this legitimately on our Nintendo systems. That's pretty sweet. Captain to Tsubasa Bobo, what? Tecmo Theater? What? It's a freaking soccer game! I was thinking with a... It's Tecmo Cup Soccer or whatever. World Cup Soccer. We have this one. I was thinking it'd be an actual game of some type. You know, like... a non-soccer game. Crossfire. I'm not familiar with that one. maybe we got this one. It looks legit. Drop my carrot drop, please. Okay. So I guess you dropped me off in the jungle with only fists. Fair enough. That's all I needed, is fists. Take out the freaking entire Vietnamese military. I assume Vietnamese because they are having booby traps everywhere. Holy crap. And now they got guns. Okay, yeah. Throwing grenades in the background. Yeah, fuck these guys. Alright, so we've got a list of games here. Apparently we had Mighty Final Fight already. So yeah, there's another Mighty Final Fight. So they duplicated games. The story start. Yeah, it's the same motherfucking game. We already have this one. There's not any ROM hack variation or anything. This is the exact same game. Yep. Everybody knows Mighty Final Fight. So there's actually like only 339 games that we know of so far, because we already had that game. Rainbow Island and Bubble Bobble 2, I think it was the same game, so those are duplicates also. I got Sayuki World there. Okay, cool. Cool. Looks like a lot of legit games otherwise, though. I have no idea what Arabian is. Let's check it out. Super Arabian. Okay. Apparently it's a really old game of some type. Maybe this is a Japanese-only game or something. I never heard of it. Oh, that looks like something I can collect. Not something that's going to kill my character. So don't grab the pink-looking bulbous things. Talk about some annoying-ass music, though, huh? All the other games look pretty familiar. Bird Week was actually featured on Classic Gamer, and this is a game we never got, and he enjoyed it. Like, it's a game where you have to, like, feed your, birds into your... Oh, wait. How do I feed them? Okay, I guess they grabbed it. Yeah, you gotta feed your birdies. How do I feed them? Oh. Huh. I killed you, Panda. Let's grab that slug, why not? Apparently a slug makes everything else slow down. Okay, that's a weird game. Alright, let's check out the next page here. Bomb Sweeper, Brush Roller, Burger Time, Chack and Pop. What the hell is Chack and Pop? I have no idea. Apparently it's a bombing game of some type. I guess we're supposed to blow up the little white things. That's what you need the bombs for. Or, I guess those are eggs. Alright, so, yeah, there's just a lot of games I've never heard of here, man. There's Bomb Sweeper, I have no idea what that is. This is a freaking Game & Watch game! Holy crap! Why, though? Not sure how you're supposed to play it. So all I could do is just move these platforms slightly. That's really weird, though. Oh, okay, I get it. You're supposed to make it to the bomb? Yeah. So I goofed up by pushing the platform. Yeah, simple, nice little Game & Watch type game. Okay, got some freaking chess, man. In Japanese, of all languages. This is not chess. At all. Why is it called chess? Alright, some of these games look legit. In case you want to hunt down a copy of Donkey Kong Jr. Math, it's got it on here, man. This is apparently a really expensive one here. Plus 73. So, are we supposed to just pick out 73? Whoa. Ha! You play it like an actual Donkey Kong game, I guess. Why is it plus 73? Oh, okay. I think, yeah, you're supposed to just get that combination. Let's get that 7 action going there. I don't have a 3 here. How am I going to get a 3? Yeah. I don't know, man. You figure it'd be something simple. I just don't know what they mean by plus 73. That's not really a math equation, okay? Yeah. Donkey Kong Jr. Math was those games that those parents that sucked ass got for you. But secretly, it was actually good because it's worth a crap load of money. So let's check out and see what else we got here. I think everything else looks, I don't know, about combat doesn't seem familiar. Field combat. Yeah, I have no idea what this game is. So you actually play as the aliens, I guess, in this one. That's a weird-ass game. It's gotta be a Japanese one, right? Alright, so let's see what we got in here. There's Formation Z. I'm sure it's probably Section Z. Well, no, it's not. It's a game called Formation Z, I guess. It's a shmup where you're playing as a soldier instead, and you can't shoot, you can't duck. So I had no idea how to shoot that thing that was just on the ground earlier. What's the 99 symbolize? Was this a Japanese one, I guess, or... Oh, that's actually a bad thing, okay. Destroy aliens' weapon. Yeah, this one sucks. I thought it'd be like Section Z, but no, no, let's be Formation Z. That's stupid. Okay. Yeah, it looks like these games are all... pretty normal. Door, that's not a real game. Door. The fuck? Apparently is a real game. So I go in now? That's all there is to this game. It's just two sprites of very small variation of... Oh, okay. It's a very simple little game. You're just supposed to get the enemies to go inside the door. Hence, door. Good times, people. That's right. Gotta shut the door. Ah, interesting little game. Door Door, though. What kind of stupid name is that? Door Door. Maybe that's just how it's translated literally into English. That's kind of funny. We got Karateka. That never came out in the States here. At least I remember. I don't know, maybe it did. Magic Jewelry. What the hell is this? Oh, apparently it's like a version of Columns or something? Yeah, it's freaking Columns. It's like a, I guess probably like a pirate version of it or something. Awesome. So if you want to play Columns on your NES for some reason, here it is. Okay, we've had enough. Alright, so let's check out a couple of games we have here. We got some Mahjong, if you want to play some Mahjong, of course. Mario Brothers, Milk and Nuts. We never got that one. That's a good one. Another one that Classic Game Room did. Don't know why they call it Milk and Nuts. That's kind of like a weird-ass name. I think I remember reading some fun fact about this was actually like the very first third-party game for the NES. Which that's really interesting if that's if that's true, man. Okay, no idea how to play it though. Got Ninja 1 and Ninja 3. Surely Ninja Gaiden. No? Oh, shoot, this is like Kid Nikki, I think, or what's that? No, Ninja Kid. Ninja Kid, that's what this is. So it's Ninja 3 then, I wonder. Well, yeah, I guess it wouldn't have been Ninja Gaiden, but we already had duplicate games. I figure there had to have been ones that were, like, duplicates under different titles. But yeah, I've played this one before on the emulator or something. But I didn't know that they made a third one, so let's see what that's about. Yeah, let's start. Did we really need that musical intro? Okay, this is something different entirely. I have no idea what this is. I think this might be a Japan-only game. These other games all look pretty legit. Puyan, that's a Japanese game. I know that for sure. Let's see. Sky Destroyer, that doesn't sound familiar. Let's check that out. Oh, wow. This is like a freaking Afterburner type game, except in World War II. That's pretty sweet. I'm thinking Japan only. That's a good one, though, man. Holy crap. It's like playing, I guess like 1942 or something like that from like a behind the plane view. Pretty bare bones, like it's obviously wearing on its mechanic fin. It's like, oh, look at this, we can do cool ass scrolling like we're in a 3D plane on the NES. Be impressed, people, be impressed. We got Space E.T., what the hell? It's Space Invaders. Why Space E.T., though? That's so weird. Yeah, everybody knows Space Invaders, man. That's one of the classics, for sure. Okay, these all look pretty legit games. We never got ER Kung Fu in the States. So that's pretty sweet. No idea what Warp Man is. Let's check out Warp Man. Okay, this is like a weird Dig Dug looking game. I don't know why I'm thinking Dig Dug. Like, I guess the character looks a bit like a Dig Dug character. And, I don't know why it's Warp Man. I have no clue what this is supposed to even be. It looks like some kind of old school arcade game, though. Like, that's kind of like the vibe I'm getting from this here. Oh, I went inside the warp. Is this like a bonus stage, or is it like a... Oh, I'm dropping bombs now for some reason. Okay. Alright, this game's stupid. Okay. There's a game called Baltron. This doesn't look very legit. This looks like a ROM hacker. I don't know, it has kind of like a Defender-looking vibe to it. I don't know why you automatically shoot a bomb, and the B button doesn't seem to do anything at all. Yeah, this is pretty much Defender, except I don't think you can go backwards. Yeah, it's Defender in a traditional shmup format, rather than the open style where you can go back and forth. You can slow down and go faster, I guess. They kind of retain that element, at least, of Defender, but... Yeah, I don't know, this doesn't seem very interesting. I'm guessing it's a Japan-only one. Unless it comes by a different name in the US, I'll have to find out for sure, people. Bokusuka Wars, that's obviously a Japan game. There's no way it's not. But there's a game called just Porter. What the hell could that be? The hell? It's a weird looking puzzle game. Like, look at these graphics. These graphics don't make sense. This just does not make any sense, people. I guess I succeeded. I think this might be a graphical hack of a game that we have. Okay, alright, let's check out Destroy. That sounds pretty cool. Oh, I think this is Wrecking Crew. Yeah, but it's like a different variation of Wrecking Crew. Okay, that's kind of weird. I guess, yeah, it is what it is. It's a ROM hack of Wrecking Crew. It's like, whoever asked for a ROM hack of Wrecking Crew? I have no idea, man. Somebody tell me. Somebody out there has got to have asked for one, right? For them to make one. I got Doughboy. Never heard of that one. Let's check it out. Game A. Seems familiar. The rock is this? Whoa, dude. What the hell is this game? This doesn't make sense! Holy crap! You're playing as a guy that can't shoot at all, and you have, like, this army of enemies that are just out to kill you. I got a key, I guess. We did it! We succeeded! We somehow infiltrated the enemy base and got the key to go further in the enemy base. This game sucks. Alright, let's check out Dragon. Easy, please. The hell is this? Oh, it's a snake. That's all this is. This is just freaking Snake. Except you play as like a dragon, I guess. Well, you have to really stretch your imagination to call this a dragon, but I suppose. Well, if you wanted to play Snake on your NES, here it is. Now, Tower of Druaga, I don't think we actually got that here in the US. So, it's really interesting that we have a version we can play on our home consoles now. That's pretty sweet. This is like one of those old school arcade games, like before RPGs were a thing. Or, well, not really before. They had RPGs, they were just like really, really not very well known. And apparently this is not a very good game. Because, like, why did that slime not die when I stabbed him? You figure that would be like, yeah, it'd be pretty obvious. Kill the slime. Oh, we didn't check out Zippy Race. I have no idea what that is. Let's see what that is. Oh, okay. I guess 180 is the fastest we can go, people. Can we go in the grass? Nope. Realism. Yeah, this A button sucks, man. I'll have to get a new NES controller, for without a doubt. The only ones I have are the two NES controllers, like the classic style, that they have problems with them. And I've got two from a aftermarket NES console that don't even freaking fit in the NES port. Like, the pins are too tight or some bullcrap. Check out Flappy. Maybe it's like Flappy Bird. Player one. Okay. No idea what this is. Yeah. This game is kind of dumb, huh? Oh, yeah, the blue rock. Yeah, I already failed. Guess you can suicide yourself, which is what I just did there. Alright, let's check out Exit X's. This looks like a legit game. Oh, I'm out of stars, I guess. That's what that was. It's like a weird-looking game, man. That sound is terrible. Diarrhea Donkey Bowl music. I think the music speaks for itself. There's, like, not any real design to this cartridge. Fruit pig. Fruit. Pig. Oh. It literally is a game where you just catch fruit. I mean, graphically, it looks like an actual NES game. It doesn't look like a typical Chinese ROM hack game. But... yeah, I know, it seems like it's kind of sucky, you know, if you ask me. This is like a mobile phone game. Mobile phone games have came to the NES, people. Alright, let's check out these. Some of these are just not real names. Galg? I'm sure it's gotta be... the freak is this? I have no idea what this is. It looks kind of like... you're playing a Galaga ship. But it's not Galaga. This is something else. No freaking idea what it is either. Is it a Chinese ROM hack of something? I don't know, this seems official enough. But I don't know, like the ROM hacks have gotten better over the years, so maybe it still is. I don't know, man. Yeah, it's not Galaga. I was hoping it would be. Alright, we don't know what Gaimos is. What the hell is that? Okay. This looks semi-familiar. It's like a 3D version of, it's like that Gyrus game or whatever, I think. In a way. It's got, like, freaking Galaga sound effects. Yeah, it seems like it's pretty crappy, if you ask me. And I guess we'll wrap up this video with Gyrodyne. I don't think that's a real game either, people. Gyrodyne? Like, where the hell do they find these games? This cannot be a real game, dude. This has to be a ROM hack of some type. I don't know, man. Is there really a game called Gyrodyne? Yeah. Well, I think that's enough for this episode. Thanks for checking out this. We're going to check out more of these games in the next episode. So don't forget to check that out. But till then, Dow Phoenix out.